Welcome to another Nucida training session to get more familiar with Xray. In order to begin here, the number one thing to understand is how to launch the test case import wizard. Now, there are two different ways to do it, but of course there's only one option. But there are two different places from where you can launch the same process. Number one, you can navigate to the testing board, and you would find an option here. Under the three lines of your test repository, but just not test repository. There are several options under that if you just click on this, right? The three lines here gives you different options to deal with the Xray instance altogether, and you'll find an option called as test case importer right at the bottom. Now this is the option, which you launch from the testing board. The same way, if you click on the app section on the top and navigate to the Xray app, you will find the similar option right here at the bottom that is called as test case importer. Now, if you click on any of this option, it will lead you to the same wizard. So, there is no difference between these two options, but importantly just giving you different ways to reach out to the one important option. But before we get started with this, let me just quickly give you an overview that what exactly we will be trying to import. And if you remember, we have been doing this for quite a while now, so we are pretty much familiar. So, if I open a particular test, we need to remember, what details do we have here and what details we would like to import. It's completely dependent on you, that you would like to import, the summary you would like to import the test cases, the steps here, for example, the action, the data, and the expected result. If you have added any custom fields, and if they are mandatory, that's certainly required to be imported, and other things are optional. On the right-hand side, there are some Jira standard fields, which you would also like to import, then you can pretty much bring them in your data as well. Now just to confirm, before going on importing, I'm taking you to the full issue view. That is all issues, and just trying to tell you that we have the last test as MFP35 and login test for app, right? So, we'll be naming our test in a different manner, that you don't feel like these tests were already in and import did not happen. In fact, the dates will try to tell the same thing that the last import has happened, or we just created a test today that is August 29 and will be not importing on top of it some other new test, right? These are all my tests as of now and altogether we have all 35 items in our instance. And again, this is just to make sure that you have a good belief in this standing. Yes, it happened right in front of us. Now, that's it. Let's jump onto something where we are supposed to prepare the data. I'm using an Excel sheet here to prepare my data, where I'm giving some column names, which are specific to the names of the fields in the Jira as well as Xray. Now, as we will be directly importing test steps in Jira, some of the things can be excused, for example issue type. If you're importing issues in Jira, for example stories or bugs or anything else, then you must explicitly define the issue types. But as we'll be not using that option, rather using a test case importer option within Xray, you can exclude the issue type. And just to show you that we don't have to mention it, that it is a test, or it is a test set, it will just continue importing a test itself, because we are defining explicitly the option as test case importer. Also, issue ID is only to differentiate or tell the Xray that, hey, there are four steps under the same test. Okay, do not misunderstand it as an issue key in the Jira, which will be auto-populated by Jira itself. This, you don't define them here. This is just to tell Xray that, hey, the first four rows belong to the same test. Don't put them into different test. Right, the next column is summary. Of course, a new test must be created. So, the summary is required and I'm calling it out as test 1, sign up validation, test 2 sign up validation again, but I'm giving them a format like test 1 and test 2. Then, if you also remember in our test, we have a test type being defined, because Xray can import or work with three types of tests, manual, generate, and cucumber, which is your BDD test. I'll show you them when I import them, right? Then, we have priority. We have the actions defined for signing up like enter name, phone, city, and click on sign a button. I'm providing some data. I'm also defining the test type of test, which is mandatory field, and the profile, and following, that I have the results window. Now, it is dependent on you, that if you would like to import labels. you want to import release versions, or anything else like environment, etc. You can go on adding the columns also to tell you that the column names are not typically supposed to be the same as that. If you have done any typos in the labels here, not at all a problem, because Jira, while importing it, will still ask you, what do you want, what do you mean by each column, right? So we are ready. All you must do is to make sure that, when you click on Save As, and you just go here, you save it as CSV. Okay, I repeat, save it as comma delimited format, because that's what you need to perform the necessary import, right? So, that's it. We are pretty much ready with this. Let's go back here, and let's make sure we have saved it. And then we jump onto our Xray instance. Now, here I'll be using one of these options. For example, let's go to the testing board and click on the test case importer option. Okay, I'll be using this option on the testing board called as test case importer, and it will take me to the test case import wizard of Xray, and right here we'll just follow the stepwise process and continue importing them. So, let's click on import CSV. You must browse the file where you have saved your file and, again, do not touch this, because your CSV is anyways UTF-8, and comma CSV stands for comma separated values. Your delimiter is comma in your file. Click on the next here, and they're asking you, which project would you like to import it? I'm importing it into my post project, and just click on next. In case you're importing any kind of date and time, then you can also define the format of date and time here to do that. If you'd like to capture them in the repository or organize them, then you can enable this and add the repository. But right now just keep it simple and sound. And click on next. Now, this is the most important part of your import process, where you must map all the information in the Excel to that of the Xray that are Jira fields. Now, issue ID and some examples will be displayed to you that, hey, if in case you forgot what you wrote in your Excel sheets, this will remind you that, what exactly your issue ID is all about. So, I'll just map them the same. Right, so if you see here, it says Xray field. Thus, it's not going to tap to your Jira basic filter issue type. Again, as we have not mentioned anything in the issue type, we'll just keep it empty. We will not map this field, if we just come back here. If you see, my issue type is empty, so I'm not going to map it at all. Now, summary is something which is important for any issue type, so I'll just capture it. Then, test type is manual. Again, we have not included this in our fields at the issue level. First, because while you create a new test, this field does not appear. It only appears after creating a test. So, this would conflict with your import. Do not map this field priority. Okay, so you may ask me a question that, okay, then why have you written it, if there's no point of importing it? Of course, because you can always ask your administrator to publish this field on the issue creation page itself, and that would be required at that time, right? So, I'm just keeping it to make sure that, you know, how to prepare your data and not getting stuck there. Now let's continue, I'll just search for action. Can you see? These are Xray test step fields and mandatory. I'm importing the same way for data Xray step field, and type of test is my type of test, again, which I created an extra test step field, and then we have the profile. My field name is user profile. Now, this is a wonderful example to tell you that your column name in Excel does not really matter how you have written it, but it should be relevant, so that it's easy for you to link them, right? But here, if you see, my extra field name is user profile, though my Excel sheet name or column name is profile, right? And that's it. We are good to go. And again, the same example here, we mentioned as a result in our Excel and in the Xray it is called that expected result. So, if you're all clear here, we are done. Let's go ahead and begin the import, and the import will happen. I think so. Okay, we got stuck here. What did we miss? What's wrong with this? Let's try again. It says Xray test type is not present, but I'm not mapping this. Okay, let's try this one more time by mapping it. Next issue ID goes to issue ID. Issue type is empty, so there's no point mapping it. So let's not map this. Summary is summary. Test type is test type. And priority is priority. Action is going to be action. Data is going to be data. Type of test is type of test, and profile is user profile, and this is expected result. Now, what's wrong here? You got the test type, which we cannot publish, while creating it. And the issue type is not necessary, because we are importing test cases directly. Okay, seems good, everything is good. So let's click on these two issues. Imported. Or you can even go back to your filter there, where you can just click on two issues importer to see them, right here. If you see exactly, we got test 1 signup validation, test 2 signup validation, and these are 38 and 39 created, right now, and we have got the priority as high. If you remember, our Excel sheet also have the priority as high. Now let's open one of them, and see what exactly the test contains. If you click on the test here, you will find the steps relevant to that. And again, if it is up to you, if you would like to import assignees, labels, components, etc. And if you see inside this, yes, we got four steps, enter name as this, enter password as this, the test is valid, right? The phone number and the city are here. And then we got the final step here for clicking on the sign up button. Right, and similarly, if we go to the step 2 that is test 2, and this should be for the second test. And here we got our results in the test case. So, this is what the test type is, right? Which we were talking about manual, generic, and cucumber. When you click on create button, you don't see this field, you see only the summary component. So, one of your administrators should publish this here at the creation. So, if you don't have a feel at the creation, you should not map it, right? What we were going wrong with is, we were not giving them the issue type itself. The issue type is test. Thus, we should map this, right? And this one is the second one with its test steps. Here, we got for example Mumbai and click on the sign up button, etc. I hope that pretty much makes sense and helps you to import a lot of your test cases, whatever you would like to import, and that certainly gives you a great confidence of saving a lot of your time. Happy testing and see you next time.